Hi, this is John Farrell with the Farrell Law Firm. Today we're going to be talking about what you should do with the sentimental items that you want to give away after you've passed away. But first, make sure that you subscribe to the channel. We put out new videos every Tuesday and Friday. And make sure you like the video that you're watching today. It really helps a lot. All right, again, we're going to talk about what you should do with the sentimental items that you want to give away when you pass away. But first, let me tell you a little bit about myself. Again, my name is John Farrell. I'm an estate planning attorney here in Marietta, Georgia. I am the author of Estate Planning for the Modern Family, and I've also been voted one of the top three lawyers here in Cobb County, Georgia, along with the law firm being voted one of the top three law firms here in Cobb County, Georgia. Well, today, we're going to talk about what you should do with those sentimental items that you want to give away. You know, back in the old days, people would want to put things in their will, like, you know, I want to leave my Rolex to my nephew, or I've got a tennis bracelet that I want to give to my daughter. And so you would put those types of things in the last will and testament. But over time, what we discovered was that people would change their mind quite a bit about these sentimental items. They would call and say, well, I don't want my nephew to get my Rolex watch. I'd rather my brother get that Rolex watch. So we would go through the process of amending the will. It's called a codicil, but we would go through the process of amending the will to make those changes. And sure enough, they would call 4 months later and say, you know what? I've changed my mind. I want it to go back to the nephew. They'd come in, we'd do another codicil, and on and on and on it would go. So there's lots of different ways that you can dispose of the sentimental items, and that was certainly an older way of doing it. The reason this has come to the forefront of my thinking lately is that I was actually watching a rerun of one of my favorite shows, Frasier. Now, for those of you that know the television show Frasier, it's about a radio psychologist or psychiatrist who dispenses out advice. And he's got a brother and a father and a caretaker for his father. So in this episode, he called them all together and he wanted to describe to them what he wanted to do once he passed away and how he was going to divide everything up. And finally, he said, so what I want you to do is I've given you all stickers that I want you to go around my apartment and I want you to put labels on all the things that you want to have when I pass away. Well, they argue a little bit about how morbid it would be to go around and put stickers on the things that they want. And finally, Frasier, satisfied that he's had the conversation that he wants to have, has started to wrap it up. And so I'm going to show you a clip of what happens next. And it's funny how I see these things in all the television shows I watch. Somehow, we'll circle around to estate planning. All right, so here you go.
Thank you. This meeting has actually made me feel better. I think I can handle my mortality a bit better now. Well, enough talk about death. Let's celebrate life with a bottle of Chateau Certain 75.
Oh, no, not the 75. I can't let you do that. That's far too good for the likes of us.
Well, you know, perhaps supposedly Les Nouveaux would be more appropriate.
Yes.
All right, so as you can see, Frasier put the bottle of champagne down on the table, and Niles, his brother, put the sticker on the bottom, hoping that one day he would inherit that bottle of champagne. Well, sure enough, there are a lot of people that do that. They will go around and maybe do color-coded stickers. Everything that has a sticker blue on it, I want to go to my sister. Everything with the circle red on it, I want to go to my brother. So there are lots of different ways to do it. The most modern way of disposing of those sentimental items is something called the personal property memorandum. Now you might ask, what is the personal property memorandum? It's actually a document that would get attached to your will that you can fill out at your leisure after you have created your will. Your will reference the personal property memorandum and say, I've created a document called the personal property memorandum or some other similar writing where I've disposed of these non-titled personal items. And in there, you can go in and you can write Rolex, nephew. You can write bracelet, daughter. Of course, you might get a little bit more detailed than that, but it's something that you can fill out at your leisure after you've created your will. That way, if you change your mind, instead of going to see a lawyer and doing a codicil to your will, you can just correct the personal property memorandum at your home at your leisure. Of course, you'll want to sign it and date it at the bottom, but ultimately the last personal property memorandum would be controlling. Ultimately, if there's a dispute about it, there are a couple of different ways it could get resolved. You could either go to the court and have them resolve the issues, but oftentimes in the wills that we create, we'll give the executor power to resolve these disputes a variety of different ways. But that is how you handle those sentimental items these days. You no longer put those types of things in your will that you want these sentimental items to go to specific people. Instead, you will create a personal property memorandum afterwards, and then you'll fill those out at your leisure with those non-titled things that you want to go to whoever you want them to go to, instead of putting it in the will. All right, so that's all we have for today. So make sure that you subscribe to the channel. Again, we put out videos every Tuesday and Friday, and we appreciate you watching. Make sure you hit the like button. It really helps us out a lot.